This parcel came today. Hopefully it's the kickstand. We'll soon see. Well packed. Complete with bolt, two springs, not sure what the spring configuration is, the bolts, touch the screws out, lol. It screws in to the other side, keep forgetting. I really don't know if these two springs need to be there like that. Or if one spring goes somewhere else. Yeah, I can't see why both of them would go there. But yeah, it all seems to be there. Not sure what the threaded hole in the end is for. And I'm not sure why we've got springs within springs. Zontes ZT1253A Tiger 15 plate side stand. Delivered by Swindon Bike Dismantlers, care of 10 Lion Acre Close, Grange Park, Swindon, SN560A. The actual thing was £14, so we've got 4 for postage. So the stand itself was £10, which I think is a reasonable price for an original stand with the spring. So yeah, I'll just go and check to see what the spring configuration is and then I'll be back. I'm back. The springs go like this to form a loop. On there, on there, and this on there. Could be a stretch. This is the second of my t-shirts that sacrificed itself closest bike I could find to this is the Lexmoto ZSB125. Just a couple of slight differences on that, the front where the headlamp is and the back where the stop lamp is. But apart from that, it looks like it's the same bike. LM2 grease, lithium based. Now the tricky part. Actually a rim there. Is that going? Small one going. We just don't know how this goes on. Gonna take some stretching. It's a 16, haven't got one. I'll use the spark plug socket. It took a while, but I finally got it on. I had to. I hooked the springs on, then I had to grab the stand, put my foot there, pull it back with both hands to hook it onto there. Then use this crowbar to tap it up into place. Put the bolt in. It was quite easy once I'd worked out a way to do it. So yeah, side stand on. I noticed the horn is looking a bit rusty and dirty, so I'll take that off and give it a coat of silver paint. ~17mm. I'll give this a wire brush in. I've used a wire brush to get rid of the surface rust. And I'm going to give it a blast of Poundland grey primer. Now I'll let that dry before applying the top coat. It's been a few minutes now, so I'll go over it with Poundland matte silver. Let that dry, put it back on the bike. So that's it back on the bike. Let's see if it works. Awesome.